Alright, so since that last game was so bad, apparently the other guy was excessive griefing me, so we're going to try here again. See what we get here. Oh, yeah. Finally, I got someone at least that I can match up well with. Jeez. All right. All right. We'll see how this goes. Got both the same Dez Bryants. There we go.
It is the second round of the Madden Ultimate Team playoffs. Right. I'm Larry Ridley in Orlando as we get you set for the NFL on EA Sports. Ahead this afternoon, we move on to the divisional round of the playoffs with what should be a good one between the New England Patriots and the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Patriots come into this one knowing that this could very well turn into a high-scoring affair. So this defense is on notice. They're going to need to be at their best if they want to get out of here with the victory. So now let's go to Foxborough, Massachusetts, where Jim and Phil.
And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
All right, here we go. Wide and hit.
First down at the 21. The offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches. And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down.
Here we go!
Carr's got it in the gun. He's wide open for the grab.
Yeah! Nice.
Touchdown puts them in front here in the first.
Oh, I love that word, momentum. The big mo. Big mo is on their side. That is a great thing to have and a good feeling as a football team.
All right.
Bush is going to run this one out. Able to move past the 20. Brought down at the 23.
50-50.
The Patriots with two extra.
And Romo, I see.
First down at the 23. Two hands on the football.
Ah.
Has the catch.
Get ready.
The Steelers snap it at the 41. He'll throw it over the middle. Can't find the target on the pass underneath. Here's a look at the offense. And if they're going to win today, this group of wide receivers must go vertical. They must open up the game for the offense. Snap it at the 41. Reggie with the reception.
Yes.
Timmons is the one who made the big stop.
Well, we still got a close game here, and you got to try to keep it that way. It's third down. You lose the football game. Don't take a chance on the offensive side. Wait for your next opportunity.
Now, looking at third down.
Under.
Yes.
As it goes incomplete. The offense stopped midway through the first, and they'll now turn to their defense.
Yeah, Jim, they're going to turn to the defense. Here we got a low-scoring game, and what they have to do is go out there on the field, find a way to stop the other offense from scoring some points.
Oh, what the frick?
Tackled down after a gain of two.
Well, the best thing we can say about that punt return, well, he didn't fumble the football.
The Patriots preparing to get things going again on offense. They took it all the way on their previous possession, mostly getting it done through the air.
Yeah, they got the leader, don't they? That quarterback, he takes control of the situation, and he goes out on the field. And I know that defense, they had great respect for him. Now they fear him. That's a tough spot to be in on the defensive side.
Double tight end formation. Anderson's going to take the handoff.
You jerk.
Second and 11. Looking across the middle, here's Bryant's tackled down after a gain of 10.
That time the quarterback throws the drag route. It doesn't get a first down, but still it's a good decision by him. The throw was right on target, and it picked up solid yards.
The Patriots break ready, cuddle ready, and show a jumbo look. Hand off. He's tackled beyond the markers.
There we
it's
go.
First down.
That time, nice job. Offensive line gives him a little hole, and he gets in there and shows his toughness and picks up the first down.
First down at the 37. Carr's on the move.
That's come on, man.
Let's take a look at the defensive starters. Carr set. Empty backfield.
We ready?
They'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. And Walker can't hold
come on.
Time.
Can anyone hold on to the freaking ball? Please.
A crucial third and long play coming up.
These are tough situations. What are you going to do on the offensive side? There's only so much you can do. If I was the defense, I would look for a screen.
The Patriots will line up. First down markers right at the 47-yard line. And the catch is made by Percy
yes.
Harvin. And in for the touchdown.
Boom.
I hope you have your blowout playbook, Phil, because this game is so one-sided as the first quarter is drawing near a finish.
Oh, shoot, you know me. I'm very limited. I only have one playbook, and that's all out. But, hey, that describes what we're seeing here so far. The offense, the whole football team, they've been sharp, and they're on their way to a blowout.
Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. The Steelers heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative. Get the defense off guard. Make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
First down at the 20. Set up screen to Bush. Burnett's all over
yeah.
the offense and brings him down.
Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Out of the gun. Drilled as he throws it.
That's what it says, but what you really need him for is to get to the quarterback from the inside or the outside. Timmons has that kind of talent.
Third and long. Walks to go deep.
Yeah!
With the interception.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just ran the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Patriots will be trying to make it three successful drives in a row as they retake the field here on offense, partner.
They got a great feeling.
Come on.
So far. In other words, they're confident. They feel good. So you need to keep calling plays. It keeps the offensive players in a positive frame of mind. You do that, hey, I wouldn't be surprised to see him march down here and score again.
second quarter is underway with this snap.
Oh, come on.
They tackle him for a loss. The Patriots have the lead right now, but you would think to keep that lead, they'll want to lean on the running game a little bit more. Anderson struggled to find running lanes in this one.
I think you're right. I think they need to lean on this running game a little bit more. The offensive line has to block better. And sometimes you got to look at the running back and go, you've got to break some to make it happen.
Games 18. The Patriots put themselves in a terrible situation. Third down, but you know what? They got a lot of talent on the offensive side, and that was an awesome job of picking up that first down. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Anderson's the receiver on the screen.
Yes.
18.
Jim, this time it's a halfback screen. Nice job by the quarterback. The halfback, good job after catching it. Picked up some good yards.
Two tight ends on the field here.
Zebra! 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 Zebra!
First down and 10.
Almost
made the catch, but the collision jarred it loose.
Walker's really hit hard that time. And I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good.
Come on.
Patriots in for the score.
Yeah.
Harvey's second touchdown of the game.
And we're talking about some of the fastest humans on earth. And we take into account you can't touch them or breathe on them. That's how they're able to get open and make so many catches.
Bush is going to test the coverage this time. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Steelers just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches look. You make mistakes on the field, they're gonna be forgiven to a point, but you got to be smart.
Boom!
Avril brings down the quarterback.
Well, that's a sign of a good defense. When you can sack the quarterback and you're just rushing the defensive lineman, you don't need any tricks, you don't need any blitzes. Man, that's talent.
Romo standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Intercepted.
Yes!
Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
But a defense intercepts a pass like that and scores a touchdown. Boy, does that give them hope. Gives them a lot of confidence. They really get the momentum on their side, and it's going to be hard for the offense to come out here and do anything after that play.
Mason Crosby ready for the kickoff.
All right. Things are rolling.
Austin's running this one out. And Delmas there that time for the tackle. That return's good for about 13. The Steelers offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let go and go out there and be aggressive.
What the
and
freak?
See if you could score some points.
D'Angelo Hall makes the hit.
Brent Grimes is terrible, man.
The 2-minute warning in this one.
He is terrible.
To the line at the 28. First down here after the completion. Reggie Bush with the catch out of the backfield. Burnett's able to read that play and make the hit.
Well, we'll see it more and more. Football thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Second down. Tony Romo will take it right from the center. Tammy's got it. First down. That's his first reception today.
Tony Romo does everything well. He moves around. He can throw it deep down the field, and he is very good at this also. Play action passes. Good fake by Tony Romo. Good throw.
Yeah. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
My goodness, what a hit. And the ball falls incomplete.
That's interesting as you watch the receiver trying to make that catch. He knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
Every time I go zones, I switch to zones there. I always don't get it.
It was just really nice. He threw it beautifully right on target. Touchdown. Two-point conversion, and it's so tough from the two-yard line. So many things to think about on the defensive side, but they were ready that time.
Harbin will run this one out. And the tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. The Patriots playing very well so far. Up big here in the second. The scores 28-6. First down at the 31. Easy catch there. No one near him. First down coming up. They're going to the hurry.
All right, here we go.
Throws the pass. Fitzgerald had it, but couldn't hold on as this goes incomplete.
All right, here we go.
Carr's gonna take it from the gun. C.J. Anderson with the catch. Burnett's there to make the stop. They hurry to the line of scrimmage.
We ready?
First and 10. And the reception by Anderson. Touchdown. They're just running it up.
Lack of hustle, bad tackling, you name it. They allowed the short throw.
All right.
To go all the way down the field for
yeah.
Sure.
That's what I'm talking about.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. The Steelers set to return the kick. Austin's got it. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23.
The Steelers' offense heading back onto the field to start the drive after the result of their last possession was a touchdown. You think they've got another one in them, partner?
Oh, I absolutely do. I mean, just look at them. They got a good football team. The quarterback has great confidence and talent. And you put those things together, that makes you good. It makes you dangerous. And I wouldn't be surprised to see them march down there again.
But they can't connect.
If you're defensive back in the NFL now, you've got to be alert for the deep passes down the field. Because not only do you got to play it well, you got to make sure you don't have pass interference.
Second down following that incompletion.
Get ready.
Set up screen to Bush.
Yeah.
He's all over the ball carrier. Going to take it from the shotgun. Looking to go deep. And that pass is going out of bounds. Incomplete. Phil, we talked to the coordinator yesterday. He thought he had a good game plan for this offense. But obviously at halftime, it's going to be back to the drawing board.
Jim, I like the thought process they've had out here in the game so far. But the players are just not executing. They're making really simple, silly mistakes. If they stop doing that, I think they can start making some good plays and get down.
That's why I picked safe zone.
On the interception
Dallas had the play on it. The Patriots come out for the next possession, having reached the end zone on each of their two previous drives.
Yeah, it's good stuff to watch, no doubt. You know, the offensive side, the offensive coordinator is right in tune with the quarterback to call exactly the plays that need to be called because of the situations when the quarterback has been hot throwing the football.
That short pass play picked up six. It's now second down and four.
Hey, we go right.
They'll go shotgun here. Another
touchdown
to increase the lead. My goodness, Bill. Halftime can't get here soon enough as it's blowout city.
It is. I know you can't wait for halftime because you scarfed down food at halftime like you haven't eaten in a week. So we don't want to keep you from that. But this game, oh my gosh, it's been lopsided, hasn't it? And you're right, the team that's losing, they can't wait to get to the locker room.
And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. That'll bring us to the end of the first half here in New England on the outskirts of Boston. We'll take a moment to catch our breath and be back shortly to Foxborough for the start of the second half. They'll take it at the 20. The Steelers offense trots out onto the field, looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in this playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
Boom. All right. What I need to start picking from now on, man coverage. Seems to work better than the zones, right, for my defense anyways.
Puts a hand. Oh, he made the catch. He caught it with one hand.
A good catch.
No need to huddle. Hurry up offense.
Well, let's go. 21.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
And it's batted down. You had to figure that, at least from a mental standpoint, they needed something out of this initial third quarter drive. But instead, it's more of the same. What we saw in the first half, they can't convert on third down.
Yeah, listen, Jim, I'm tired of talking about how bad they are on the offensive side. They're not getting it done. Let's talk about the defense. It's been outstanding, and they deserve everything they've done here today. They have played hard and smart.
Oh, Brent Grimes, you freaking blow.
A foot race to the end zone. The 10.
Can't wait to get rid of that idiot.
What a play. What a run.
That dude sucks.
Well, Jim, it's almost impossible to guard these guys nowadays as they go down the field. These wide receivers, they have feet like ballerinas. And even though you get tight coverage, they're so quick, they can get open and make the catches.
What the frick? I'm pressing the button, you dumb game. All right.
And the hands team,
oh my God.
His job recovering the onside kick. The Patriots come out to open up the second half. They were hitting on all cylinders in the first half, Phil.
Yeah, be smart here in the second half, Jim. When you start out, just find out what the defense is thinking. And once you get a feeling about what they're going to do, then you start taking some chances.
The Steelers call.
He really wants me to get something else here.
Second down now.
Hey, we're going up.
Three step drop. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands. Third down now. Carr comes out in the pistol.
We ready.
Walker, the target. Parker's in on the tackle.
This is awesome down by the head coach, the offensive coordinator, and the offense. Just keep picking up those first downs. You got a big lead here in the second half. Keep that clock running.
Anderson's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Carr's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under.
You gotta try to avoid this as a quarterback. Don't throw off that back foot unless you have to. When you do, there's just no way you're gonna be as good if you had good balance. That time the throw's off the mark.
Second and 10. Anderson's gonna secure the handoff. Burnett's there to take him down.
The Patriots have really been dominant today on the offensive side. In the red zone now, they just take the football and they run it right at the defense and pick up solid yards.
All right, here we go.
Carr's going to take the snap from the shotgun. C.J. and Patriots in the end zone.
All right.
Well, we've seen a lot of terrific passes by this quarterback.
Oh, at least our dead run it a little bit.
Showing his arm strength, showing his great touch. That's what you have to do to be a great quarterback in this league. And a touchback.
Need to make sure I have some safety help back there. Freaking Brent Grimes is not good. Not a good cornerback.
Romo's setting up now in the pistol. First down at the 20. To the ground. Sheard's the one who made the big stop.
Steelers running back that time. He makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards. Take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Tony Romo uncorks the long pass.
Well, the most common thing that most offensive coordinators do in the NFL in third long situations, they're going to call a play where they probably don't think they're going to pick up the first down, but they're looking for field position.
Oh my God, Brent Grimes, you freaking blow so hard.
Take it the distance.
Oh, Brent Grimes sucks.
Burnett's the one who brings him to the ground.
Oh my God, he sucks. Brent Grimes is terrible. Every game I say he sucks. He does. He freaking sucks.
You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
So first and goal to go. Bush has got the screen.
Come on.
For the touchdown.
When you look back at every single game, especially on the offense,
freaking Brent Grimes,
you
man.
Games by how freaking well you sucks. The red zone. That was an awesome job by the offense. They found a way to score the touchdown.
The Steelers in position. They're going to go with the onside kick. That kick came right out, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. Patriots offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum, and when you feel you got the momentum on your side, you got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right play.
He's drilled as he throws. That's second down coming up. From the gun. And it's
dang it!
Just couldn't hold on.
Come
to
on. Hold on to
it. Jim Nance, even you can coach the team in a situation like this. You're winning big. It's third and long. You know what you do? You hand the football off and you punt the football.
Hey, we're gonna run.
The Patriots will take the snap from the 45. Makes the catch in open space.
Good job on the offense here with a good lead in the second half. Picking up that first down. And that's what you're going to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can, and keep picking up those first downs.
The Patriots snap it at the 31. He'll pick up 7 this time.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Anderson's lined up in a single back formation. The tack was made, and that'll move the chains.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
Now first and 10. Catch made by Rob Gronkowski. Has 12 on this play. Coming up to the line at the 7. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Zebra!
Here is the first snap of the final quarter.
Scoring
hit that time. Knocks the ball free.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
We ready?
Second and goal from the 7. The margin is increased with another touchdown. Bill, we're early in the fourth, and they continue to keep the pedal to the metal.
Oh, absolutely. The offensive coordinator, he wants to pad the stats of his offense. Keep putting up those numbers and total yards and watch them rise in the rankings. And, hey, sometimes you got to do that is do what's good for the offensive coach.
Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Steelers have it at the 24. Looking long.
Oh my God, Brent Grimes! Terrible, man. Terrible. He is so cracked. My God, Brent Grimes is freaking terrible football player.
Get down there and score a touchdown.
It's out of bounds, incomplete. To the line at the 37.
Let's go.
Get ready.
Second down and 10. Reggie Bush with the catch out of the backfield. Bush is tackled right at the 28. Getting set as fast as they can. The Steelers take it from the 28. For the deep ball,
there we go. Finally.
The Steelers will second guess that play call. That time on third short, they throw the football. Everybody thought they were going to run it. They were trying to be too clever, and it backfired. Now it's fourth down.
The offense is still on the field right now. Fourth down, and they'll need to pick up two. The Steelers take it from the 28. Look at that all the way home.
Oh, that got freaking smoked there.
Touchdown. And they're still showing some spirit here, chipping away at that once gigantic deficit.
Yeah, you know what they're doing? They're just showing professional pride. That's what they're doing out there, Jim. And that's the way you're supposed to play the game. Forget the score, play hard, and just do the best you can. They wanted more excitement, more tension, more decision-making as a second guess in the NFL, and now they're going to have it. This two-point conversion, more teams are going to do it because they don't want to kick the extra point from the 15-yard line.
That's a timeout call. The Steelers setting up now, trying to recover an onside kick. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. The Patriots take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
All right, here we go.
It'll be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy, and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing. Can the offensive line continue to dominate?
Second and 10. And here's the toss. Anderson's tackle right at the 42.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stopped him for a short gain.
Red 18.
Third down and 7. He'll throw it over the middle. Pass
Dude, no one can hang on to the freaking ball. Holy freaking crap.
Crabtree's one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
No return as this goes for a touchback. Last play before the 2-minute warning. First down at the 20. Going deep. And that pass is going out of bounds, incomplete. 2 minutes remaining, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Patriots' defense now is going to go nickel. Second down and 10. Romo's unable to find his target that time.
That's what's expected in the NFL nowadays from the players, especially these receivers. They're so aggressive, so athletic. They go all out for every catch. That time, he just lets it all go. Not able to make the catch, but I'll give him an A for effort.
Romo's back in shotgun formation. Johnson's got a pass that has some heat. Tackled down at the 47.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better. Finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
Connect.
Brent Grimes gets smoked every time. I need a new quarterback so bad right now.
Why? Because they're trying to make some yards after the catch. That was the problem that time.
And they can't connect.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Ken? They are all over the receivers, all over the field. Nowhere to throw it, and this results in an incompletion.
It'll be third down. From the gun, Romo. Romo's unable to connect that time.
The Steelers really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
The fake is on, and they're looking to pick up the first. Pass.
Oh, yeah. Percy Harvin.
Over Harvin.
Well, I love seeing plays like this. A big punt when you throw the football, it doesn't work. Hey, it's easy to do these things in practice, but when you got to do it in the game,
I didn't want this play. I wanted to run it.
And sometimes you just cannot execute the play.
First down at the 40. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it.
Well, Jim, they got the lead. There's not much time left. Run the football, and this clock keep it moving, and you can win the game. Take no chances. Don't jump off sides. Don't create a penalty, and put two hands on the ball.
We ready? I'll let the game run out a little bit.
Patriots take it from the 43, running right through the trenches.
Well, this is not a surprise, Jim. This is what you do. You run the football, you play the clock. This is called managing the game, and it's all up to the head coach getting this done.
Third down.
All right.
We ran it wide and yank. Wide and yank.
Third and six. Airing it out.
Oh!
Well, you get the touchdown in the last play of the game, but it doesn't change anything.
Oh!
The player's going to be happy about what he's done, but the game is all over.
The Steelers set to return the kick. Boom. Bush is going to test the coverage here.
The Steelers' offense comes onto the field for a last play or two before this one's over. There's nothing they can do now to pull this one out, Phil.
Yeah, listen, it's very tough to even get the courage or the energy to finish this game off in a situation like this because it's so disappointing. And I say to them, don't take any chances, don't get hit again, and just get off the field.
He's able to come down with it.
My God, Brent Grimes. Oh, my God, he sucks.
Where you had to just hold your breath because just after one touchdown was scored, there would be another one shortly right behind it. A high-scoring affair and a memorable day indeed.
It really was. How exciting, really. The gym, it was just, you said it, one big play after another.
All right.
But it happened because both of these teams, they have some superstars.
So for Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.
My God, how many catches did, well, I think all the catches were pretty much against freaking Brent Grimes. Look at this. I so need a new freaking, yeah, all these were against freaking Brent Grimes. All these long receptions, all because Brent Grimes got smoked. Ugh, I need to find a new cornerback fast.